Some nervous, I give them all this. I owe this. In fact, I know she missed the way I flow this. I'm focused. I know I used to buy my strap before this. I'm focused. It's slow it down, down. Alright, let me blow this bitch. I'm famous. I blame this. I'm blue cash in the purple hang. Get my penthouse. Ooh, skyline. The clear is bright. Keep your optics. Pop the couch. You lift the word. It's pop my top on the 105. Here with no power steering. Ah, oh, oh. Luxury. Chitty ching ching. Could buy anything. Drop that. Oh, oh. Calibrees. 3 degrees low, make it happen. Me drop that. Oh, oh, oh. There we shoot, can't shoot, stop with that.
Summer's over, now it's getting cold. We fighting way more than usual. Maybe it's time to go. Whoa, let me slow the pace down for a second. No sense in making moves.
So it's a matter of, you know, just kind of everyone kind of, you know, like when we talk about the beginning of the fall, you know, even like when we talk about crops and things of that nature, right? So like, you know, life is all about planting seeds. And so like, you know, you think about it like crops and shit like that. It's like, you know, you plant your seeds in the springtime. They live in the summertime where you water them, give them sun and love and attention, you know what I'm saying? So they can grow and flourish. They flourish and then they ripen in the fall time, and then you pick your fruit, you know. But you have to pick all your fruit because in the winter everything is dead. So in the winter it's like the fall kind of brings anxiety as well, because, you know, things are changing. And so you want to make sure you have enough to sustain yourself through the harsh conditions of the weather, you know. So, you know, I kind of translated that into the song. So I'm talking about, you know, a relationship. Like I said in the other video, it starts in the seventh house, which is all about relationships and being in a partnership, but a one-on-one partnership where, you know, the funny thing is, like, I like to look at things and through oppositions. And so, like, you know, we talk about the seventh house, we can't help but talk about the first house. And so the seventh house is kind of about relating to others in a partnership one-on-one. But see, there's two, you know, that's two, right? But it's kind of like it's one-on-one, you know. So it makes two, which is the number of relationships and relating to another person outside of you. But it starts with one, you know. If there's two ones trying to come together to understand each other, so, you know, this creates tension. But it's also like, you know, on a energetic level, it's the balance between what's right for me and what's right for our relationship. And a lot of times in relationships we go through situations like that where it's like, you know, you and your partner might be going through a hard time, but it's like, you know, everyone kind of goes through that flux between, you know, should I leave because that's what's right for me, or should I stay and make it work because I care for this other person. And so that's kind of like what this song is personified or lyrified, written. I don't know what I was trying to say. But anyway, so, you know, summer's over, now it's getting cold. That's what I was just saying. Fighting way more than usual, you know. Now we're going through a lot more emotions. We in a confined space, you know what I'm saying? And like I was gonna say, and this brings me back to my other point, you know, when, so, you know, you got the single people who are out enjoying their life and shit like that. I don't mean to say it like that, but you know, they're out having fun, but it's mindless fun. And so, you know, when you're in a relationship, you can't really have mindless fun like that. Like, you can, but, you know, sometimes it doesn't play out like that. Like, you still have to be conscious of the relationship you're in, you know what I'm saying? Because there's always temptation around you, and it's just like, it's like, I don't want to make it seem like relationships are a jail cell, but, you know, it's like, it is in some way a restriction, because you can't do, you know, all of the same things you can do when you're single. You have to consider how that other person feels. And so, like, the people who've been in a relationship all summer, you know, it's like, you know, and this is not just speaking for everyone in that situation, I'm just kind of giving an example energetically for you to understand kind of like the energy, right? It's like people who've been cooped up in a relationship all summer, you know, they might start actually getting into more fights and more tension, because now it's getting cold and there's more of a reason to stay in the same house. At least in the summer, y'all was in a relationship, but you could go places. Now, you know, y'all stuck in the house, and it creates more tension, you know what I'm saying? So we fighting way more than usual. And, you know, that's the thing about us, you know, we're spiritual, you know, as a spirit, right? You're an individual space. It's your individual space. But we're down here to relate. And when it comes to marriage and things and relationships, we're choosing to relate to another one, another individual. And we have to come together in some common ground to create, you know, that's like the joining of two energies, aka sex, where two energies come together and they produce a whole new energy, and that energy is a whole new world that y'all create together and y'all co-create. And you know, healthy relationships co-create this shit in a way that, you know, enriches both of both individuals. But even though you're shitting and toxic relationships drain each other to create that world. But see, when you know, it kind of, it's like this, it's like, even though y'all share this world, y'all need to leave that world every now and then and go to your own world to make sure you're correlating your individuality correctly, you know what I'm saying? Because otherwise you'd be too passive and you'll be controlled and manipulated by your partner. But you know, we leave the, you know, so we created this world in the middle, but every now and then one of us has to leave and tend to our world and X, Y, and Z. And when relationships move apart, that's because both individuals are in their own world maybe, and it's creating more separation into that middle world, no longer has anyone correlating, you know, planting seeds in that world, and so that world dies off naturally, you know what I'm saying? So that's kind of like to give you an idea or concept of how, you know, relationships even work. So like, that's why I said, you know, we fight it way more than usual, maybe it's time to go, you know. And that's kind of like that second thought energy of being like, you know, maybe I should do what's best for me, maybe this relationship isn't meant to last that long, you know. But then it's like, whoa, let me slow the pace down for a second. Because when you're going through thoughts like that, a lot of times, like, you can make, you know, don't want to make any wounds I regret.
Yeah.
Let me slow the pace down for a second. No sense in making moves I regret. It's just sometimes I forget. And so, like, that's saying, like, you know, like I was saying about us being individuals, you know, spiritually. Naturally, our spirit creates situations and circumstances to create that space anyway, you know. And a lot of relationships fall because, you know, we don't understand that, you know. Whether you feel like you want to suffocate your partner, some people get insecure and they want to just spend more time, but it's like, we all need space in our own individual shit, you know. But you know, that's why relationships are a choice. Relationships aren't something that just kind of happen and sustain themselves. They're hard work, you know what I'm saying? You got to put your energy into it. And so that's why a lot of relationships fail in the first place.